हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर इंग्लिश क्लास। एज़ योर सिलेबस हैज़ बीन डन, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट द सैम्पल पेपर। वी गिव यू सैम्पल पेपर सो दैट यू कैन डू प्रैक्टिस फॉर योर एग्जाम्स। सो द सैम्पल पेपर आर बेस्ड ऑन दैट ओनली। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस दिस एंड सॉल्व। आई विल सॉल्व विद यू दिस सैम्पल पेपर। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, द सैम्पल पेपर कंटेन्स 3 to 4 सेक्शन, दैट इज़ सेक्शन ए, सेक्शन बी, सेक्शन सी एंड सेक्शन डी। सेक्शन ए कंटेन्स रीडिंग सेक्शन हैविंग 2 पैराग्राफ्स, अनसीन पैराग्राफ्स। ईच इज ऑफ ईच अलॉटेड मार्क्स ऑफ 6 मार्क्स एंड द नेक्स्ट वन इज ऑल्सो 6 मार्क्स। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल डू दिस फर्स्ट वन। A1, क्वेश्चन नंबर A1, रीड द पैसेज एंड आंसर द फॉलोइंग क्वेश्चंस। देयर वॉज अ यंग मैन हुज ग्रेजुएशन डे वॉज नियर। He used to admire a sports car in a dealer's showroom. He knows that his father can afford it. Does he ask him to buy that car for him as a gift? As the graduation day approached near and near, each day the young man was desiring sign that his father has bought the car. Finally, the graduation day came. Before the young man could go to set venue, his father called him in his study and told him that he was very proud to have a fine son like him. And then he handed his son a beautiful wrapped gift box. Curious but little disappointed, he opened it and found a Bible in it, which is beautifully laced with leather and his name embossed in it in gold. He got furious and shouted at his father and said, "This is all what you bought for me from your money." He put the Bible on the table and stormed out the house. Then he got good job, got a good wife and 2 children and a beautiful house. After many years, the young man thought that he should go and meet his father as he was very old. He also didn't see him since the graduation day. But as soon as he packed for going, he received a telegram which said that his father passed away. He quickly went to his home and regretted for what he did. And after everything was fine in few days, he searched for some papers and his dad's almirah, and he found that Bible which he didn't receive as a gift, and he found that Bible as a gift. He opened the Bible and saw keys of car falling down. He grabbed them, and in the label attached to it was written the dealer's address, and also it was written paid in full. Tears filled his eyes. He regretted for what he did. So this is the unseen paragraph that we did. I hope that you all have marked the difficult words in the paragraphs. When we will find out the meaning, then it will help us. So moving to the next part, here are the question answers. We have 2 questions, we have to find the answers. Now, what did the young man admire? Here, the young man admire and want admire a sports car in a dealer's showroom. Okay, sports car in a dealer's showroom. Why did the young man ask for the car? The young man asked for the car as a gift, and he knew that his father can afford it. Next, why did his father call him in his study? His father called him in his study to told that he was very proud of his son. Okay, next is, what was the gift received by young man? What was he expected? He was expected a car, but what he got? He got a Bible beautifully laced and his name embossed with gold. Okay, next, what moral did you get from the story? So here the thing arises that what you think, what should be the moral? First of all, what can be the moral? You just tell me. It can be like, don't be angry, or what can be done? First, your action reflects your works, and what can be, you will be responsible for your deeds, okay, and be satisfied. So four are there, anyone you can write. And then, what did the young man received after he packed for visiting his father? What did he receive? I think we have read. You also think, Veda, that he received a telegram mentioning, here it is, which said that his father passed away. Means his father is no more now. Okay, so this was the answer of section A. And if I just give you some words, the words are not mentioned here, but still I want to give you to find out the opposite, means antonyms. First is appointed, okay. First is appointed. Second is your emptied, okay. First is appointed, second is emptied, okay. And then is one more I would like to give you. It's far. Next is far. So out of these three, okay, you have to find out only two and send to me. Now moving to the next section A, we have done. Now this is the turn for the next question of section A, that is A2. Read the poem and answer the following questions. If there is a future, there is time for mending. If there, read it carefully. If there is a future, there is time for mending. Okay, just a minute. If there is a future, there is time for mending. And next is, time to see your troubles come to an ending. Time to see your troubles come to an ending. Life is never hopeless, however great your sorrow. If you are looking forward to a new tomorrow. If there is a time for wishing, then there is a time for hoping. When through doubt and darkness you are blinding groping. Though the heart be heavy and hurt you may be feeling. If there is time for praying, there is a new day breaking. Thank God for the promise, though mind and soul be aching. If with harvest over, there is grain enough for gleaning. There is a new tomorrow and life still has meaning. Okay, so this is a poem. Life is never hopeless when, however great or sorry you are looking forward, life is never hopeless when you are looking for a new tomorrow. Means when you are looking for the new day, it means that every cloud has a silver lining. Means after every dark night, morning come. We should offer our thanks to God when a new day breaking. Means when you have just passed out the night, then for when the new day begin, you always should pray to God. If there is a good harvest, there is a hope for new tomorrow, that life is still having meaning. If you are able to pray God in the days of deep sorrow, there is a chance for cure of your pain. Your soul be aching means cure of your pain. You will get the good grain means your pain will be cured. If anybody has courage to face problem, his troubles will automatically be ending. Okay, so next one here. Now we will discuss section B. Section B is the writing section. Okay, section B is the writing section of this. Now writing section, we have some notice and application. So notice writing and application writing we have already done. We have discussed about the format, but still I'll tell you one more time about the format, about everything. So first question of section B of writing section is, now question number one, B1. As a head boy and head girl of your school, write a notice suggesting the students that they should be punctual and regular. The advice has been given to you by your principle. So now you know that how many parts notice has. First of all, this is must for you to draw a box for notice. So after drawing the box, in the very first line you will mention inside the box, you will mention notice, NOTICE. After that you will mention the school name, ABC. ABC is in capital, ABC school. Okay, next come to the next line, skip one line. Okay, then mention the date, date. Don't write date, date, only mention directly date, like today is 30th of April, so you will mention 30 April. Okay, and then coming to the next line, you will mention the title, the heading, that for what you are going to write it. So as per the question, that they should be punctual and regular, so the heading will be punctual and regular, and write it in the middle. You will mention the date at the left side, okay, but the heading you will mention in the middle, be punctual and regular. Either write the whole in capital, be punctual and regular, or write B in capital, punctual P, and regular R in capital. Okay, coming to the next line, we will start the content of the notice. What is the notice? That all the students are hereby informed, that hereby informed, or the hereby suggested to be punctual and regular to the school as for the disciplinary matter. If found not following, then the necessary action will be taken. Full stop. Then you will write necessary action this by the principal. Okay, by the principal. Full stop. Next line you can skip. After that you will write head boy, and then in the next line you will mention your name. Clear? Next. Now coming to the section B, that is B2. That is B2. B2 is your Sudhir wants to write an application to his principal requesting him to remit his fine for coming late continuously for 4 days. Sudhir wants to write an application. Here you will follow the format of application. What is the format of application? Format of application is like, first of all you will mention the name of the school, okay, and after mentioning the name of the school you will mention you will skip the line and mention the date. After mentioning the date you will again skip the line and mention the subject, and then after subject you will mention the salutation. Okay, salutation sir or madam to whom you want to write the application, and then start content. So first of all we will start writing the school or ABC school or Rishikul Vidyapeeth. Coming to next line, okay, coming to the next line you will mention Delhi, skip one line and then mention 30 April, okay, 2020. Coming to the next line, here the subject, application to his principal requesting him to remit his fine. So request to remit the fine for coming late, here you can mention this. Okay, request to remit the fine for coming late, or request to remit the fine, this can be the subject. Request to remit the fine, request R capital. Okay, remit R capital, fine R F capital. Clear? Coming to the next line, subject sir, sorry, here it is salutation sir. Then I students, I Sudhir